Maybe the question is something else.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Chopra, General Sharma, General Panu, all the distinguished guests this morning. Well, there's something known as jam side down. So our books are still on the way. Apparently they're caught up in traffic. They should be here in the next 5-10 minutes. The book on 1965 has hit the stands just 3 days ago on the 5th of October. It's been published by Alep. It's a follow-up of my earlier book on the 1962 war, the war that wasn't. And we are now going to start work on 1971. So one of the questions which has been asked is that since this was the 1971 50th year, why didn't you time it for this period, which would have made a lot of marketing sense. But I felt basically these anniversaries are, they're markers, but basically these books require a lot of time. And the big advantage of sitting back and watching everybody else write on 71 is it gives me a lot of additional material to look at when it's my turn to actually sit down and write about it. 71, of course, my father commanded 18 Rajput. 18 Rajput, by the way, was also at Nathula, and the barbed wire incident started with the battalion when they were laying out the lines. And in fact, we lost Major Harbhajan Singh on that fateful morning. 1965 has taken almost 2.5 years to write, just the writing part. A lot of it is also on the Air Force, which is, I've had the privilege of having shot 2 major films for the Air Force in the past, Salt of the Earth, which was the 60th year of the Indian Air Force. And that was funded by J.R.D. Tata way back in 1992. And then, of course, we did Akash Yodha after the Kargil War. So it's the 65 book also very heavily, again, thanks to the work done by people like Jagan and everybody, made my job a lot easier. It also focuses a lot on the events that actually happened vis-a-vis the Air Force. 65, the scope is absolutely stunning. It is actually, and I think, you know, a lot of people have written some excellent books on it, but it's all been kind of semi-piecemeal. Nobody has tried to really look at the entire thing. Now, one of the things which everybody believes is that the Navy had no role in 1965. But actually, the war probably started because of an exercise held by the Navy off the Kathiawar coast. Now, in 1947-48, we all know about the Junagadh landings. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto's father was the Prime Minister of Junagadh. He opted for Pakistan. The amphibious landings actually resulted in his plans going awry. And at that time, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto was the Foreign Minister of Pakistan. So when they saw this whole exercise happening, whatever we said, it's a exercise, they looked at it as a matter of intent. This was immediately after 62. They felt India was trying to flex muscle. We were probably looking at Karachi. And at that time, we've also had 50 independent para brigade as the other thing. So, you know, if you put those things together from the Pakistani point of view, it does make a certain kind of sense. So then they launched, the trouble started at Kanjal Court. I don't think Pakistan had actually set out initially to test the water, so to say. But they did, because that was an opportunity for them. There were new doctrines which had come in with American equipment, etc. And of course, the British came into play. There was a ceasefire. And just before that happened, Kargil happened. Because for the first time, we captured some posts in Kargil, which was, the mindset here was, again, General Harbhajan Singh. You know, he just kind of pushed these guys and said, go take these posts. And so we retaliated from the run-up. To counterbalance the run-up cuts, we had gone into, we had taken some posts, both 4 Rajput and 1 Guards were the 2 battalions. But then we had to hand this back, which later happened in Tashkent also. Then there was a lull. Very little has been actually written about Orba Blaze, but actually that is a very important period, because that is when the entire thing about Punjab and Rajasthan and all the plans were drawn up. Then Pakistan launched Operation Gibraltar. I've covered that in great detail. We retaliated again. It was a kind of a cat and mouse game which was going on. So every time they would do something, we would do something. They would do something, we would do something. So we took Haji Pir, we took the Kishan Ganga bulge. And when that happened, they felt threatened. They said, ki ab ye Mirpur aur is area mein bhi aayenge, Muzaffarabad mein bhi aayenge. So they retaliated with Operation Grand. All kinds of things started to happen. Then we assault across Hor. We actually failed to get even to the Ichugal Canal except for three Jat, which did get across. And there are various reasons for it. One of the biggest failures, and which I've really dwelt upon in a big way, is the complete lack of coordination between the Indian Army and the Air Force at that time. Then there are reasons for it. And one of the reasons was that General Chaudhary, who was the chief, the Indian Army chief at that time, was 10 years senior to both the Naval and the Air Force chief, not only in age, but even in service and rank. So they were both, one was an admiral and the other was a air marshal. And he was a general. He was 4-star, they were 3-star. They were retrospectively upgraded later. Then, of course, all the fighting that happened in the Sialkot sector and the Barmer sector, et cetera, et cetera. So it's actually a very thick book. It's about 500 odd pages. And maybe that's one of the reasons it's taking so long to get through the traffic to get here. So it should be here by the time the session ends. And hopefully once it does come, we will get the opportunity to get General Sharma and Dr. Sanjeev Chopra and General Panu to help release it. So we get the mandatory photograph, which we can then splash all over social media. Thank you all very much, and I do hope you enjoy reading 1965 as much as I enjoyed writing it. Thank you.